No one ever thinks that their kid at 12 years old is gonna get cancer. You just don't think that. And you're no way, shape, or form prepared for it. It's like somebody socks you right in the stomach as hard as they can. And the drive down to the cities was terrible because we didn't know. You know, you don't know what the prognosis is.
Her asking if she's gonna die. What do you tell a 12-year-old?
She called me from the clinic and said, you know, you need to get down here. She's got cancer.
And she had her blood counts checked and found out that she had leukemia. She had a disease called acute myelogenous leukemia. The treatment for that disease is very aggressive treatment. And in Jordan's case, she had some really harsh effects of the chemotherapy besides her immune system being low.
When I first found out I had cancer, some of my worries were, will my friends treat me differently because I have cancer?
The chemo took its effects on her. I mean, to see a little girl that's that active to become, she didn't even want to go walk down the hallway to get free ice cream.
Children who have life-threatening disease such as cancer or life-threatening blood disorders such as sickle cell disease need a lot of help in that journey. And we found that the arts in particular have true healing potential.
Just the team that they put together for you with social workers, child life specialists, art therapy, music therapy, the social worker, made it possible for me to be down there. And
Julie had to be out of work for 6 months, unpaid. It would have been difficult, at best, for us to survive if they wouldn't have had all those facilities and assets available to us. The Ryans made that seventh floor possible with their help. And you look and you see their name right there and you think how much those people must have cared and how much they've touched our lives by making it possible.
Very quickly, she turned her attitude to being really positive, like, I'm gonna fight this, and this is just a thing I'm gonna get through, and I'm gonna do it.
I'm happy that I beat cancer, because now I get to, like, hang out with all my friends, and I get to play basketball and softball. I just want to play college basketball when I'm older.
And Jordan wouldn't be doing as good as she is today without the doctors and the nurses and just taking care of her and making sure that she came home.